بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. Welcome to the AFM Doctors to Pass session, December 21. And today is the day 3. And first of all, you must have to reply me about the clarity of the voice. Same file. Are you people getting the voice? That's good. You will get the handout to, today's handout will be uploaded after the break. Don't worry. Now it's time to move more aspects of the syllabus areas. The first 2 days we covered about the direction of the quality revision with a particular investment appraisal 50 marks question, and another day that's something about investment appraisal with the multi issues including the forex aspect, including some areas related to international investments like purchasing power parity jury. And both of these days I hope that you people enjoyed your valuable sessions, and that was really eye-opening for you. I strongly suggest all of you that you must have to take synergetic effect of the sessions for December 21 exams, including September 21 and December 21 P2P. If you really want to get advantage, you must have to add on the September 21 P2P seminars as well, webinars as well. Anybody of you who have already watched or watched the limited part of the September 21 sessions, because the questions in December 21, it's not repetitive as compared to September 21. There was different question in September 21 practice to pass session, and for December 21, these are different session. So if you, and even some theme aspect, some theme also different. September 21, I strongly focused with the examiner reports, reading of the examiner reports. But here for December 21, some more thing I have added with you, with the term called quality revision aspects. So anybody of you who are watch, who have been engaged to watch the September 21, can you please reply? No one is there. Yes, Orlando, that's good. Hamza, oh, that's good. I hope that you were getting more advantage. You were getting more advantage with that September 21. Yes or no? Can you please reply me, Orlando, Hamza, Muhammad? That's adding on. That's adding on September 21 plus December 21 practice to pass session. These both provide you the proper guideline, the proper guideline for the December 21 sessions. Okay, let's start the today's session. Okay, Amjad, I will share the September 21 PDF files as well. You will get access by tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Don't worry. Don't worry. Now start the today's session. I haven't uploaded the day three material. The day three material, some of the part will upload.
One particular document of the question will upload very soon after the break, but another detailed document will share after the session. Okay, I have already shared you people the G drive link for the material for day one, day two. So you can please add with the WhatsApp group and then work out accordingly. Yes, can you please reply me? Is my voice clear to all of you? Okay, let's start. So we are going to start a particular topic. You people know the topic called acquisition, merger, business reorganization, and financial reconstruction. That is the very important part of the syllabus. We will discuss a particular question with the today's session. The important point is that, is my voice clear to all of you? Okay, let's start. So you people know very well that there is a question, there is a syllabus detail area that's acquisition, merger, business reorganization, and financial reconstruction. And first of all, whenever you start the topic of, for example, acquisition merger, you must have a checklist. You must have a checklist of this document. The checklist of the about the topic acquisition mergers, you must have to aware that you have already done or you have a good knowledge about all these contents. Number one. Section A, the exam scope, acquisition merger can examine section A question, 50 marks question with the maximum marks 30 to 35. Because with 50 marks question, examiner integrate other part of the syllabus as well. And this topic can also examine with the section B with a 25 marks question. This topic is a combination of theory and calculation. If you people only done with the calculation aspects, you are actually with the wrong direction. The important thing, the key to success is about two things. Key to success: good enough knowledge of entire syllabus. Entire syllabus area. And how do you know that you have good enough knowledge? You can check your knowledge with this checklist. Number one, you must have an ability to discuss about the business growth, that is organic, inorganic way. What is the meaning of inorganic way? That's called vertical, horizontal, conglomerate. You have a good knowledge about the synergy, not only calculation, but also about the theoretical aspect. You people have a good knowledge about the business valuation technique. These calculations, all matters. You have a good knowledge about the debt valuation. You have a good knowledge about how to handle the things with the mode of consideration. And you can easily analyze the situation with respect to acquirer and acquiree. Moreover, you have a good knowledge about the defensive techniques. You have a good knowledge about the legal aspects and how to handle the theory that's related to exam. Exam here means examiner examined this part of the syllabus where theoretical aspect about all above plus something about the case. Yes, this handout will be available to you, but after the session. That's important. That's very important. Moreover, this is the possible scenario. This is the possible situation the examiner examined with the cases. For example, you must have a good knowledge of valuation of equity, acquirer, target, combined company. You have a good command for the complication of the advanced WAC. You have a good command for the synergy, theory, and calculation. You have a good command for acquisition merger reasons of failure and how to avoid it. You have a good command for the evaluation about both consideration. That's premium offered, target company shareholder and acquirer. You have a good command to the about the case specific limitations, assumptions, case specific issues. You have a good command about the legislation, about the minorities and like this. Good command about the defense strategy. So this is, you people know very well that it's not possible for me to discuss everything with this practice support session, but this is what the right direction, and that right direction means the honesty and your hard working. The benchmark question for AFM December 21 exam. This is what the list of the question. This is what about the list of the question. You have to attempt these questions. You have to attempt. West Parle already with September 21, I have attempted. And I think that I have also discussed the Karen question. You can check it. So that's important. So this is what I have provided the direction to you. Now it's your responsibility to obey this direction. That's important. Now it's your responsibility to obey this direction. That's important. Are you getting the point? What I'm saying? Now let's start the today's session with the specific direction. For example, one of the question with the CB format. AFM practice exam 2. AFM practice exam 2. Do remember that AFM practice exam 2 is actually the question of December 2018. This is December 2018 question. That's important. Now, moving towards here. What about the question is? Start reading question with the requirement. This is the question. Well, assume that you people are in a position to simulate this question. Assume that you are in a position to simulate this question. First, what you should do first, read the requirement and the question and identify your situation. And identify your situation. That is that part of the syllabus with this checklist. With this checklist, I have already covered or not. If not, first of all, you have to cover this topic. Either theoretical, either calculation. Do remember, this is what acquisition and merger part. Another part is about business reorganization as well. Business reorganization as well. Same thing about business reorganization. Business reorganization. Same thing about. And same for financial reconstruction as well. That's important. I will provide you the checklist after the class. Don't worry. Now, first of all, this is what about the question? The question OPAO is actually a question where examiner examined multiple area of the syllabus. Multiple area of the syllabus, including the theoretical aspect of the business reorganization, including multiple area of the acquisition, and some part of the business finance as well. So first read the requirement. Can you please reply me? Are you people with me with full of motivation? Do you people remember that? What should be the target? The target must be for all of you people to motivate yourself that the result must be under 40%. Result must be under 40%. So are you with me about this? Mr. Noman requesting me must have to conclude the session by 11:30. Thank you for this greeting. I will try my best. But if something important and still continue, it's possible that I will extend the session. You can close the session and then by morning you can watch the session on the recording. Okay, start. Number one, distinguish between the MBO management buyout and MBI management buying. And this "and" is very much important. Discuss why OPAO board of director might have sold buggered through MBI. Okay, so 4 marks here and having two components. Number one, straight distinguish between MBO, MBI, and then connect the case of the MBI with the case. Connect the MBI knowledge with the case. Number two, what, explain what portfolio restructuring and organization restructuring involve. And discuss the possible reason why change in type of shareholder may have opao change from being conglomerate to one focusing just to business sector. Okay, something about portfolio restructuring means application. Why change in the type of shareholders? Something about type of shareholders. From being conglomerate on focusing to some two business sectors. Okay, 5 marks. Then prepare a report. Once again, estimate the value of equity. Value of equity, opao and tie before acquisition. And of the combined company after acquisition. This is a very common question examiner examine with a calculation. And estimate the percentage gain in value of each opao share and tie shares under each of the cash shares and mix offer. That means 22 marks about calculation. Evaluate likely reaction opao and tie shareholder to the acquisition offer. Professional marks means 7 for 11. Then distinguish between IPO and reverse takeover. And discuss whether IPO reverse takeover would be appropriate method of burger to obtain listing. Eight marks. So candidates, how much marks available for calculation? How much marks available? Only 22. That is 44% time you need to spend on calculation and 56% must be for discussion. Must be for discussion. That is the point. And you have to balance your answer and balance your preparation, balance your revision according to this. Now come on. One by one. First of all, before entering the question, what you should do? You must have to evaluate your situation. That have you already knowledge, good enough knowledge about all these things? If not, you must have to refer your studies and work out accordingly. Is this clear, all of you? Now, question. Now, question. Come on. Number one, the background. Quickly. Around 7 years ago, opao company, a private conglomerate company, involved in different business, decide to obtain a listing on a recognized stock exchange by offering a small proportion of its equity shares to public. Number one, this opao is a private conglomerate company. You know, What is the meaning of conglomerate companies? Multi-diversified, having different divisions of business. For example, in the Pakistan, there's a group called Shirazi Trading, having 16 divisions called Honda, called Battery, called Bank, called Biomedical Equipments, multiple 16. That's called conglomerate company. And they wanted to obtain listing on a stock exchange. Before listing, the company was owned by 100 shareholders who were closely linked to the OPAO company and had their entire shareholding wealth invested in the company. However, soon after the listing, these individuals start selling their shares in OPAO. And over a 2-year period after listing, its ownership structure changed one of many individual and institutional shareholders. Okay, so they have now become listed from private to public. And after the listing, individuals start selling shares. And 2-year period after listing, ownership structure have changed to one of many diverse individual and institutional shareholders. That's very much important, especially for the last part, reverse takeover and IPO. Simple word of conglomerate means multi-diversified business. They have a very diversified divisions. For example, 10, 12, 13, or I can say in the portfolio of business, they have many, many different divisions. They are not focused on limited business. They have a multi-diversified. Okay, quick. As a consequence of this change in ownership structure, OPAO company board of directors commenced an aggressive period of business reorganization. Okay. Consequence of change in ownership structure, they have changed the business strategy and aggressively business reorganizations through portfolio and organizational restructure. You people must have good enough knowledge about portfolio reorganization and organizational restructuring. Portfolio reorganization means you have to change your business portfolio. For example, I have been doing business since last 10 years with six diversified business. But after COVID-19 pandemic, I have decided to sell off some of the business units. So I've decided two or three businesses I'm going to sell and focusing on the remaining part. This is called business reorganization. But business reorganization not just means sell off, withdraw. Business reorganization also means some sell off, some other purchase. Means, for example, I have three businesses. Bank, airline, textile. I've decided to sell bank, number one, and getting the funds from selling the bank, purchase or expand my airline business. So reorganization includes some withdrawal plus some acquisition. Only withdrawal also basis reorganization. Withdrawal, sell off plus acquisition, also business reorganization. And only acquisition, it's not called business reorganization. That's a topic of acquisition merger. And what is the meaning of organization restructuring? Organization restructuring is a different meaning. Organization restructuring means we have to restructure our business manner. For example, one of the way of the restructuring is changing in the hierarchy of the business, from tall management to wider management, or wider management to tall management. So that is restructuring the way to conduct business, the way to conduct the business. And this organization restructuring exclusively theoretical part. Moreover, this resulted in OPAU company changing from conglomerate company focusing just to business sector. Okay, that's very important statement. So they have decided to change their multi-diversified issue to just focusing on limited business, two business sectors. That is financial services and food manufacturing. The financial press reported that OPAU company had been forced to take this action because the change in this type of shareholder. So press media mentioned that actually they have OPAU company has some pressure about this action. The equity market seems to support this action. Okay. And OPAU share prices have grown strongly during the period of restructuring after growing very slowly initially. OPAU recently sold a subsidiary, Buggered, through management buy-in. Although it also had option to dispose of Buggered through management buyout. But they preferred by management buy-in. First of all, you have a good knowledge about management buyout and management buy-in. Management buyout means the company going to sell the business to existing management. And existing management will purchase with own equity plus the external venturers. Okay. The another point. The company going to sell the existing company to the external management. That is management buy-in. Some external management will purchase our business, having same experience. For example, I have a business of electronics and I'm going to sell it. First option, MBO, my own management will take up. Second option, MBI, some external, another competitor or another company who has been engaged with the same experience of electronic will come and take up the business. That's management buy-in. Do remember, management of the competitor company will take up, not the competitor will take up. Some external management, the group of employees, the group of directors with venturers will take up my company. In a statement, OPAU company BOD justified this by stating Buggered would be better offer controlled by MBIT. They are justifying that MBI will better control by, sorry, the company will better sell, will it's better to sell the company with MBI rather than MBO. OPAU is now considering acquiring Thai company. And details of the proposed acquisition set out 824. So this is what called the business reorganization. What business reorganization means? One of the units and getting some cash and focusing on to existing business by acquiring another company, that's Thai company. That is called reorganize. Now the situation have diverted towards acquisition. And do remember, you are simulating your question. Whatever the requirement you have read, now you are reading the main part of the question. So try to connect the main context of the question with the requirement. Like A or B part, it's 100% theory. where examiner asks MBO, MBI. So this first background, we can connect with the MBO, MBI. The second part of the portfolio restructuring reorganization, also we can connect with this part. But about this report, including calculation, that's exclusively for the acquisition. So we are now entering with the tie. Tie means acquisition. Acquisition means in question, the calculation part. So you have to read the question by connecting with the requirement aspect as well. So automatically the scenario will build up once you complete the reading of the question. Now, I hope that all set from my side, the screen, the engagement from my side, all the things are. Huh? Okay, Thai company is unlisted company. Okay, OPAW going to purchase a company Thai which is unlisted, the very much important point. Involved in the food manufacturing. Okay. OPAW company BOD is of the opinion that range of products produced by Thai will fit very well with its own portfolio, leading to cross-selling opportunities, new owner version, and larger market share. Okay, so fit well with its own product, cross-selling, new innovation, larger market share. That is all meaning about something, justification of synergy. That is the synergy. I don't think so. That is there right now requirement about the. Okay, now is this perfect now? If you comfortable, okay. It's your wish. Okay, so unlisted company and they will fit with its own product portfolio, leading to cross selling. New innovation, a large market share. The BOD also think, there is a possibility. There is a possibility for the economies of scale and scope, such as shared logistic storage facilities, giving cost saving opportunities. This is also about something related to synergy. So actually this is something about justification. This the board of directors believes will lead significant synergy benefits and lead to significant and therefore its opinion that OPAW should make a bid for Thai. So this is what about the background why OPAW should purchase the Thai. Okay, now move on. Financial information. OPAW company has, OPAW means we are OPAW 2 million shares, currently trading 2.5. So here 2,000 million shares and 2.5 each share means the price is given. But the Thai is unlisted. Thai company has 263 million shares in issue. And current market value of debts is 400 million. Okay. In most recent profit before interest tax, 132 million. After deducting tax allowable depreciation, non-cash item of Thai company makes annual cash investment 243 million, non-current asset and working capital. Estimated that cash flow will grow 3% annually for the foreseeable future. What this paragraph about? Cost of capital 11%. What this paragraph about? This paragraph, it's about indicating the value of, calculate the value of company or value of equity by free cash flow method. By free cash flow method, the one thing that's important. Okay, this is what about the information. Moreover, combined company. This is the paragraph about the combined company. What they are saying about the combined company, if APAO acquires Thai company, it is expected that the combined company sales revenue, 735 million in the first year, and annual pre-tax profit margin 15.4% for the foreseeable future. Okay, this is important. After first year, the sales revenue will grow by 5.02% every next 3 years. It can be assumed that combined company annual depreciation investment to maintain at the current level. However, in order to increase sales level, the combined company require additional investment in the first year 109, then 0.31 for every dollar will increase in sales. So number one, depreciation and reinvestment remain same, but extra investment required this for the sake of the free cash flows. After the first four years, it is expected that combined company free cash flow will grow. After first 4 years, expected that combined company free cash flow grow 2.4% annually for the foreseeable future. The combined company cost of capital 10%. So here in this question, no complication about the cost of capital. It is expected that combined company debt equity level maintain 40-60. In market terms, after acquisition has taken place, both OPAO and Thai company corporation tax annual rate, 20%. And expected that it will not change. It can be assumed that corporate tax payable in the same year. This is the another part. Okay, then the question complication about proposed, that is financing. Payment methods. It's very simple. OPAO company board of director proposing Thai acquisition has made one of the following payment methods. It's a common point. It's a very common point. A cash offer 4.4. Cash offer is one of the most simplest point. Through a share for share exchange, where a number of Thai shares are exchanged for number of OPAO shares. But in this question, numbers is not mentioned. We have to identify by own, such as 55% additional value created allocated to the shareholder and remaining 45% additional value to the shareholder. What is the meaning of additional value? Here the meaning of additional value, can you please reply me? You people are not participating today. Do reply me, do participate. That's important. That is about synergy. Okay. Then throw a mixed offer. What is the mixed offer? Cash payment of 2.90 per share and one OPAO company share for each Thai company shares. It is estimated that OPAO company share price will become 2.6 per share. It is estimated that Hopao company share price become 2.6 per share when fix offer is made. Similar acquisition in the food manufacturing industry have normally attracted a price premium between 15 and 40% previously. Okay, we will discuss this point later. This is three methods. Now, next. The future plans. Following MBI and MBO. Following the MBI, the BOD, Board of Director Burkhardt, announced that intention was to list the company on recognized stock exchange 7 years, within 7 years. BOD is discussing whether to obtain listing through IPO or through a reverse takeover. That's important. But it does not have currently strong preferences for either options. And this is directly related to the last part of the question. Eight marks. So candidates, now it's time for the working. One more time, we have to read the requirement to fix the understanding of the requirements. Number one, distinguish between MBO, MBI. The very first thing, distinguish between MBO, MBI, and why Opal company BOD might have sold Burger through MBI. Number two, what portfolio restructuring and organization restructuring involved, and discuss possible reason why change then the type of shareholder may have Opal changed from being conglomerate to just focus on two business sectors. Number C, report, estimate the value of equity Opal, Thai and combined company. Estimate the percentage in value of Opal and Thai cash with cash share for share and mix, and evaluate the shareholder offer with the professional marks. What we will read the term professional marks, free marks for, and distinguish between IPO reverse takeover. Discuss whether IPO reverse takeover appropriate for the Burger company. Now come on, this is the time to attempt the question. If I'm going to attempt the question with the sequence, first of all, yes students, what do you say that? Are you getting the point how you will read the question? And once you read the question, if you are not comfortable with the topic you have covered till now, first of all, go and get the revision. That's an important point. Now, come on. Sir, if we are moving towards the question. Question, Opal company examined December 18, 50 marks. Yes. The very first thing, distinguish between MBO, MBI, and the very important thing, and discuss why board of director might sold Burger through MBI. What the first thing you have to do? Plan. Now you people are become used to number one, time management. Four marks, 7 minutes, 2 minutes for plan. 2 minutes for plan. Okay, AXA, we'll discuss this point. Number two, time marks management. What and how much to write? Two well explained points. Knowledge plus connect with the case. Number one, you have to think about before writing what to write. This picture is very much important, what to write. Now I am giving you 2 minutes to think about what to write. You tell me, you must have to exercise your brain for this question, what we should write. You please reply me what to write here. If I'm going to explain two well-explained points, what two explain points in your mind, what's in your initial mind? Either this activity you have to perform with the scratch point. Part A, two well explained points. What two well-explained point? Number one, number two. Just a mindset. Just a mindset. Very good, Hasan Tariq. First, I will define MBO and MBI. Number one. And number two, why MBI? Just a sketch in your mind. Why NBI? If you do this type of activity, believe me, your quality of answer will automatically increase. Why NBI? Why NBI? Some reason for the NBI. Some reason for the NBI. External management have better experience and strategy to run this business as compared to internal management. It's not mentioned in the question, but you have to put your own idea. Number two, arrangement of finance. Arrangement of finance means OPAO can get quickly, with more flexible manner, quickly to get the finance from external, from MBI rather than MBO. Moreover, this is only for 4 marks. One line explanation for MBO, one line explanation for MBI. That's all. You will get 2 marks. Why MBI? Why MBI? You have to put maximum 2 points. That's all. If you know more about it, control your emotions, control your emotions, because examiner can only provide you the maximum marks for number one. Number two, another important thing, not the rote learning, just defining. Also incorporate the wording to connect the case. Now, come on. This is your answer. Read it carefully, giving you 30 seconds. The important thing is stick your plan and write it accordingly. Whatever you have planned, write it accordingly. Very good. You are answering with me. Very, very good. But the important point is this. You people are answering me in a scattered way. But you have to arrange your all ideas in one particular description and write it accordingly. Number one, MBO, what does that mean? Involve purchase of the company by management, running that company. Here, this is the connection of case. Hence, Burger current management team would be buying Burger company from a power company. Management buy-in involves selling Burger company to management team brought into from outside. This is what the beauty of answer. This is what beauty. Beauty means craft. What does that means? Craft. Graph mean you have explain your idea with case connect, with application. Application means case connection, means one line. Here you first mention what is MBI, first one MBO, then connect case. Here you just add one shot, two things. Explanation of MBI with the attachment of the case. That is the point. So if you are indulging to practicing the question, believe me, your expertise for the exam and your professional life definitely will increase. How to communicate the things smartly, just one or two lines to connect with the case. That's all. Then that is called the beauty of the answer, the crafting techniques. That is what you people will definitely learn if you go with the professional life. Now, another point. Why preference? Why MBI? Number one, may have felt that a power company board of data may have felt that Burger current management lacked fresh ideas and strategy, which could have driven Burger forward successfully. Instead, it may have felt that a fresh team, skills, experience gained externally have had a required innovative ideas and skills. And I must say, moreover, it may be that the external team of the manager may have the finance available more quickly, whereas internal team management may not have the finance to place Burger company at the time. So it is possible that management team with Burger and OPAO has decreased agreement with the past, and OPAO board of director may believe two management team would not able to gather in the future if needed. Thus, BOD may have felt that the fresh management better option. What I personally think, this is extra point. Third possible point. But what I think, this is enough. One and two for the four marks. This is extra point. That is for your knowledge. That's good. Otherwise, for exam, this for four marks. Define with case. That's the first thing. You will get two marks. And this one is why MBI. This is two marks. That's all. That's all about this. Okay, next point. The part B of the question. The part B of the question. The part B of the question. Again, why portfolio restructuring and organizational restructuring involves? Sorry, explain what portfolio and organization. And this and is very much important. Discuss possible reasons why change in this type of shareholder may have OPAU company change from being a conglomerate to one focusing just two business sectors. Number one, plan your answer. 5 marks, 9 minutes, 3 minutes for plan, 6 minutes for execution. The important point. What's the important point? What's the important point? Thinking. This one. Ideas, blinking of the ideas is the key point. Marks management. 3 well explained for 5 marks, 3 well explained points. Now, you have to exercise your brain. Brain exercise. It's time for brain exercise. What you will write, do let me know. If you are sitting in the examination hall, this activity of the thinking, either with respect to this scratch card, or you can brainstorm with your mind. If you're simulating at the home or at the office, either with a scratch card or by talk to yourself. Talk to yourself. What should be the point? Maybe you talk to yourself just standing in front of the mirror. But be cautious that nobody observing you. Otherwise, you will declare something else about you. Thinking about that, what if you are discussing with yourself or talking yourself in front of mirror and someone observing you? But mark my word, this will provide you the best confidence if you are able to talk yourself that what should be the answer. Anyway, this is about the sometime other I will discuss the studies of psychology, educational and student psychology, that's separate subject. Okay. Okay, you have 15 to 20 seconds. What you will write? For 5 marks, I have to define the portfolio and organizational restructure. First, explanation of portfolio and organizational restructure, and try to connect with the case. Explain. Number two, why OPAU? Why OPAU? Change the strategy or behavior of business. Strategy business means shifting towards from conglomerate to focus two businesses. This is the question. But do remember that you have to read the requirement of examiner. Here examiner mentioned after and discuss possible reason. Why change in the type of shareholders may have made a wise change from being conglomerate to focus to business. Here, examiner particularly mentioning you to discuss the things in this manner. Discussing the thing in this manner. I strongly suggest you have to mention that point. If examiner mention you something that you have to discuss with this particular scenario, with this particular direction, you have to follow the direction. Here, examiner mentioning possible reasons with the concerned point of type of shareholders. Actually, there are two type of. Number one, the first thing I will explain here. If we are moving towards a multi-diversified to only two businesses, means we will focus to limited business and using our best experience. Using our best experience to maximize the wealth of shareholder. Number one. Number two. First, this is a generic point. Number two. Examiner mentioned class of shareholder. If mentioned class of shareholder, you have to mention this. Actually, there are two class of shareholder. Number one class of shareholder who is in favor of extended portfolio. For example, these are general public. For example, these are general public. Which, what does that mean? General public means the shareholders who are already not well diversified and who don't knows how to develop the portfolio with the shareholding. For example, I am a shareholder. I have, for example, $100,000, but I don't know how to spread my money with different businesses to develop the portfolio. But on the other end, one of the company that's called a group of companies having 16 divisions. So I am putting the money of $100,000 with that company, with that group of company, because I know that that particular company already well diversified. So what I don't know how to make portfolio, the company will definitely spread the money with the different portfolio and I will get the advantage of the portfolio management. Means spreading the risk to the different class of shares. But another class of shareholder who don't prefer extended portfolio. For example, institutional shareholders. Institutional, for example, you are a company having 1 lakh total shares. One of the shareholder, one of the bank is the shareholder of your 40% shares. One of the insurance company, one of the investment company, for example, having a shares of 20%. The institutional shareholders, the banks, they are already well diversified. And they don't want that the company make the portfolio. Because if the company makes the portfolio, it's very expensive to establish new business setups. Rather than if asset management companies or the banks want to develop the portfolio, they just collecting the different number of shares from the share market. So first of all, you have to think about it. I am expecting that you people have assumed something about it, have a knowledge about this, but you have to recall the things. And then apply the case accordingly. Number one, simple. Explain. Define, that's all. The first, number one. Portfolio restructuring involves acquisition of company, disposal of asset, business units, subsidiary through divestment, demerger, spin-off, MBO, MBIs. Organization restructuring involves changing the way the company is organized. This may involve change in the structure of the division in the business process, other changes such as corporate governance. The aim of either type of restructuring, either type means portfolio or organization, increase the performance and value of business. That's all. Here, examiner, the model answer not connect with the case. You can connect with the case. Here, OPAO, you can mention that. That's having a plan to sell the business and through the MBI and acquiring other Thai company, just a mention. Number two, multi-diversify, which is so-called multi-diversify versus only two business. First, just make explanation and then class of shareholder. You can write, you can read it with the theme. Can you please read it quickly? I'm sorry. Whatever you have planned previously, apply the things accordingly. First of all, focusing on the business with more expertise. Number two, the class of shareholders. Two class of shareholders. Number one, who are interested with the portfolio. And number two, only the institutional shareholders. Candidates, are you getting the point how you will attack the question with respect to the acquisition and merger as well? Can you please reply me? Hello, hello, hello. A lot of persons here, 100 of persons here. Please do reply me. Waiting for your reply. Are these things valuable for you? How to handle the thing accordingly? The very first thing to handle the thing, that's the honesty. The very first thing, that is honesty. Thank you, Aksa. You are continuously responding. That's appreciated. Really appreciate that will result the confidence of yourself as well. And you must have to thankful to the ACCA Pakistan and the Thabani School of Accountancy for this particular sessions. Yes. Now candidates, I strongly suggest that you have to take a break right now. For the 7 to 8 minutes break, then we will discuss more first about the calculation, then about the report writing. Okay, take a break for 7 minutes. Okay, take your time. Okay, class break is over. Can you please apply me about a presence? Okay, come on. With the case. Now it's time for the part C. Part C, prepare a report. And for the sake of the preparation of the report, the very important thing we have to work out for the calculations. Now, come on. This is the spreadsheet. And settle your spreadsheet first. And this is what about the requirement aspect. I strongly suggest that you people try to attempt the question with my side as well. Means you also work out simultaneously. Okay, start. So number one, the requirement number one is estimate the value of OPAO and TAE before acquisition and combined company after acquisition 10 marks. So it's a very simple requirement. It's a very basic requirement. So we can put it as appendix one. This is appendix one. Is the screen visualization clear to all of you? Okay, that's good. Okay, appendix one and appendix one, number one, the value of quickly. Value of equity prior acquisition. Make it clear. A very basic question about this. Okay, one by one. So what is actually the target? What is actually the target? Here the target is to calculate the synergy, simple as that. So for the sake of synergy, talk to yourself. First, we have to identify the individual company value. For example, OPAO company. It's given, it's very simple, it's given. It's given like this. Here, OPAO company 2000 million shares, currently 2.5. So it's simple. 2000 multiplied by 2.5. It's very simple. It's equal to 2000 multiplied by 2.5. That's 5000. And that's amounts millions. And you have to mention here that all figures. Okay, come on. That's OPAO. Now the point is Thai company. Thai company. Thai company is unlisted company. Yes. Unlisted. So share equity value is not given. So if equity value is not given, the examiner will definitely provide some clue. Here, not specifically mentioned by free cash flow, but the data availability represents that we can work out with the free cash flow. with the free cash flows. Now work out with the free cash flows. How to calculate? It's very simple. Take out PBIT. How much the PBIT here? That's the operating profit. Do let me know. 132. Do let me know here, left side. Thai company 263 million shares, current markets valued at 400. Most recent profit before interest and tax. Yes, do reply me, all of you with me. Now, tax depreciation quickly. Free cash flow. Start with operating profit, but reverse working. First have to adjust the tax matter. Tax allowable depreciation and the non-cash expense, that's 27.4. Add back. Then capital expenditure. Thai company annual cash investment. Cash investment. Cash investment. That's value 24.3. That should be minus. And that's the working tax on PBIT, operating profit. Tax on operating profit 132 multiplied by how much the tax rate here? Here mentioned the tax rate. That's 30%, 26.4. So number one, this is free cash flow of equity. Now, of firm, of company is equal to sum 108.7. And we have to use here VAC. No complication of the VAC here, VAC is given. Last line, VAC is 11%. VAC is 11%, not the combined company. For the Thai individual company, 11%. If we wanted to value with the free cash flow, we also need to identify the growth rate per year. And that is 3%. So now we have to work out of the value of firm. Now we have to calculate with the value of the firm. What is the value of the firm here? Can you calculate it? It's very simple. Value of the firm is equal to 108.7 multiplied by 1.03 divided by 11% minus 3%. That is the value. It's very simple. The simple formula, free cash flow, 1 plus, no need to mention the formula, growth divided by VAC minus growth. No need to mention formula. All clear? Do reply me here. The mixture of the calculation and the discussion. The mixture of calculation and the discussion. Any problem? Any problem? But do remember that this is the value of firm. How much the value of debt? Value of debts. If value of debts, it's given here. It's given. That is 400 million. That is 400. So value of equity. That is 1400 minus 400. Simple round off. It's equal to 1400 minus 400. 1000. Value of tie equity. So total value. Operating individually. Yes. Any problem here? No. If they are working individually, that is the way. Okay, now the requirement part A, requirement first part before end. It's over. Now, another part. And what's the another part? Value of combined company. That is post acquisition. That is post acquisition. Now you please start. How to calculate the value of combined? Here is that information, combined company. And here, if we working with the combined company matter, the information is something about first 4 year and after 4 years. The information is about first 4 years and after 4 years. So value equity. First 4 years, that is working one. And year four onwards, we have to work out accordingly. That's the total value here. Means it's better to work out once we determine the value of equity, then compare with this. And then we will determine the value of synergy. I strongly suggest that all of you must have to, especially for calculation, try to work out with some pull factor. Pull factor means, first of all, identify what should be the value. What's our destination? What to do? We need to do value of synergy. Then make some reverse working accordingly. That is the point. Now, come on, another point. Come on. That's value of synergy. Yes, try to pull factor. Normally, what we do with the push factor. Push factor means somebody just work out what the calculation, and if someone asks him or her, what you are doing, where you want to be, and the person that don't have any answer, that's called push factor. So come on. Number one, year one to year four, working one. Working one. And working one, we will work out accordingly. That's year one to year four. Year one to year four. Yes, start. Sales revenue. Here mention in the question, sales revenue with 5.02% growth. 5.02% growth. The value of sales. Here, set the second paragraph. After first 4 years. I'm sorry. The first paragraph, first line. The combined company sales revenue 7351 for the first year. It's a first year. And then sales revenue will grow 5.02 every year. 7351. Okay. Now it's equal to 1.0502 multiply 1.0502 7720 control C control V, and that is what the value sales. Then pre-tax, profit 15.4% of sales. That is the value. Yes, that's simple. 15.4%. Apply control C and control V. You just quickly work out and focus more about the calculations or theoretical aspects. Tax 20% is equal to this one multiplied by 0.2, but here minus figure. Then additional investment. How much the additional investment? The paragraph is very much important about the additional investment. Listen carefully. However, in order, first paragraph, last line. However, in order to increase sales each year, combined company will require additional investment 109 first year and 0.31 for every increase in sales each next year. So how much the value minus 109, it's simple, is equal to minus increase in sales year to 7720 and increase 7351 multiplied by 0.31. Once again, is equal to minus sum is is equal to minus bracket 8108 minus 7720 multiply by 0.31 120. Hello, can you please reply me, all of you with me? Additional investment, and that is what about the free cash flows? Free cash flows. Now come on, free cash flow is equal to sum 797, control C, control V, free cash flows. And now you wanted to work out with the present value of free cash flow at the rate. How much the discount rate? How much the discount rate? 10%. You just put the simple formula. No need to calculate the discount factor, then present value, then total. It's equal to NPV 0.1, comma, select all. That's all, 2706. Once again, it's equal to NPV, bracket open, 0.1, comma, that's all, 2706. That is first fourth year. That is first fourth year. And you can put here. Yes or no? Yes. Why? You said allowed in exam. Why not? This method don't have any marks. Okay. Hassan asked me, sir, you use a shortcut. I am feeling worried that examiner will deduct my marks. Why? Come on. Let's check with the marking scheme. Let's check. Just get rid all the fair. Appendix 1, Appendix 2, Appendix 1. This is Appendix 1. Equity value, power, tie, free cash flow, estimated value equity. This is combined value. Value of combined company, year 1 to year 4. Value of combined company, year 1 to year 4. And value of combined company, year 4 onwards. Is there any mention that? What the methodology you will use? Any marks for the methodology? No, you have to put the present value factor, all this. Do reply me, yes or no? Then use this shortcut, feel free. Enjoy your exam. Enjoy your exam. And in fact, save your time from calculation and allocate this time to the theory. Why not to theory? That's all. This is first 4 year. Now, another point. Four onwards. Year four onwards. Come on. How to work out year four onwards? You can work out directly. like this. Here 4 onwards. So you first pick the value of this 923. Multiply by after 4 years, what is the discount factor? Oh, sorry, growth factor 2.4%. 1.024 divided by bracket open 10%, 0.1 minus it's simple perpetuity 0.024 bracket close and then multiply by fourth year discount rate 1.1 fourth year power minus 4. That's all 8494. 8492. Sir, what you did? Actually, I took the value 923 multiply by 1.024 divided by bracket close 0.1 minus 0.024 multiply by 1.1 discount factor fourth year power minus 4. I just did this. E28 923 8494. Yeah, that's why you use this. I use 1.1 power factor minus 0.4. Why I'm going to the formula sheet and then taking the formula? Why open this formula sheet? Formula, where is formula sheet? And then go towards for this 10% fourth year 0.683. Why? And put this value. You can do this. Save your time. Simple. Okay, if you are using calculator, it's your wish. Otherwise, no need. Using calculator is your own wish. So total value is equal to sum 11200. What is the value of synergy? Is equal to 11200 minus the 6000. It's simple, 5200. Value of synergy, that is 5200. Class, are you with me? No. Something. Okay. I'm sorry. No. This is the value of combined company. Huh? Just a minute. I got a mistake here. Value of combined company. Value of combined equity. We have to identify equity. Where it's mentioned that the expected debt to equity level maintained 40-60. 40:60. So we will work out multiply by yes. This is the value of. Hello, is there any confusion or it's clear to you? Do reply me. Yes, yes, yes. So value of synergy is equal to 6720 minus 6000. That's this one. So what's the individual importance? These values are important. Number one, value of OPAO. Value of cow. Value of combine. Value of synergy. These are important for the usage of the report. Yes, it's comparatively easy. Now, this is appendix one. Westphalen. I discussed the Westphalen and also the another question, Chakola with the September 21. You have to watch the video for the Chakola. Chakola, it's a very important question. You must have to attempt it. Chakola. Chakola is the question of March, June 21. And I attempted with September 21 P2P webinar. I will give you the access of the Excel file as well with the report as report writing. And I also discussed the Westphalen. That was also the very good question. That is the point. Okay, come on. Now appendix two. So what we have done till now, that's important. What we have done till now. For the report, we have determined this 10 marks. We have done with the 10 marks. Now, we have to work out percentage gain in value of OPAO and TAI shares under each of the cash, share for share exchange and the mix offer. That's a point. Come on. So this is what the another tricky aspect of the question. That's a question about. Appendix one. Now come on. OPAO company board of director proposing Thai company for the acquisition to be made through one for one following method. But you have to drive your question with the expectation of the requirement. Means you have examiner mentioned you have to calculate percentage gain percentage gain for tie and opao under the payment methods and what are the payment methods. It's better to work out with the pull factor. Pull factor means you have to drive what to do. That is the drive what to do, huh? Cash offer, share offer, mix offer. And we have to work out with this. With this. Number one. So one by one. Very important thing you have to consider that. Very important thing you have to consider that. That this is very, very common aspect examiner examine. This is very common aspect examiner examine. The percentage gain with respect to the opao, with respect to the acquiree and acquirer. Do remember one important point. This percentage gain means, always remember, how much premium given to target company. Always develop a mindset in this manner to target company. The very first thing. How much premium given to the target company? It's always based on the synergy. If I say to you that you are acquirer, and you are going to give me the premium, why will you give me the premium? Why will you give me the premium? What's the reason? You will give me the premium because of the reason. With the acquisition, you will get some synergy, and always provide the premium towards from the synergy. Always provide the premium from the synergy. That's a key point. And furthermore, if you are sitting in the examination hall, examiners sometimes ask for the percentage gain only with respect to the acquiree, sometimes only with respect to the acquirer, sometimes both. That's important. Here I have chosen the question because examiner asks here with the both. That's a key point. Now come on. Next point. How to work out? First is the cash offer. First is the cash offer. Start working. Here, cash offer is the most simplest part. cash offer. Number one, tie. A very simple formula, value per share. That what tie, if we are going to acquire tie, what they will lose, they will lose one share, and the value of tie, it's 1000 divided by how much number of shares of the tie. Can you please reply me? 2000 shares. No, sorry. Sorry, 263 million shares. So 1000 divided by 263 is equal to 1000 divided by 263. That is 3.8 value per share. The cash offer. What is the cash offer? The cash offer here, 4.4. So gain per share. Gain per share 0.6. So what's the gain percentage? A simple formula for the gain percentage. It's 0.6. It's a gain over 3.8 and multiply by 100. Okay, come on. It's equal to 0.6 divided by 3.8 multiply by 100. And that is 15.79%. That is called Okay, come on. Do remember that? That is the point of your tie. Now, Opal, if this acquisition matters and we have provided the 15.79% shares, so we have how much we have the synergy? We have synergy. Synergy total. How much the synergy total we have? That is 720. And this distribute to tie. How much to calculate is equal to if value per share 3.8 and we are providing 15.79% premium and multiply by 1000 shares. Are you getting the point? If once again, if the share price is 3.8 and we are offering 15.79% and number of shares 1000. So that means out of 720, 636 or 600 provided. To tie. So remaining. Remaining synergy or synergy to OPAO is equal to 720 minus 600, 120. Can you please reply me? Is that clear, all of you? Okay, one moment. Some calculation mistake here. Sorry. Some calculation. I'm sorry. Okay, once again. Now the very first thing is that. OPAO has a total synergy with this acquisition. The total synergy is 720. Yes, the total synergy is 720. And we are offer premium to tie. And how much the premium? The premium is 0.6 multiply by 263, not 1000, 263 shares. Once again, the premium we are offering 0.6 multiply by number of shares 263. So it's equal to 0.6 multiply by 263 is equal to 158. So synergy remaining. Synergy to tie is equal to 720 minus 158. That's 562. Is equal to 720 minus 158. Is that clear? Is that clear? This is what the synergy to tie. Their total shares that's 2000. It's in the question. So synergy per share is equal to 562 divided by 2000, 0.28. And so-called gain percentage 0.281 divided by what is the market value of share? Market value of share, that's already given 2.5. Let me check. 2.5. Yes, 2.5. It's equal to 0.281 divided by 2.5. And that is what the percentage. 11.24%. Okay, candidates, can you please reply me? Is that clear, all of you? Is that clear, all of you? After this question working, we will discuss the theoretical part as well. The very important thing is that the cash, if we offer them to cash, OPAU will get the gain advantage 15.71, TAI 11.24. Okay, number one. Number two, share offer. Number one, before considering share offer, we have to consider what is the point. Share for share exchange, number of TAI shares are exchanged for number of OPAU shares. 55% of the additional value created from acquisition allocated to shareholder and the remaining 44% value created to OPAU shareholder. Okay, it's a very different way examiner examined. They not mention how much number of shares. We need to identify how much number of shares. But here mention that whatever the share for share, 55% value, the final working is 55% additional value created to TAI and 45% additional value created to OPAU. And this is not a percentage gain. This is just additional value, means they are assuming that synergy allocations. So synergy, that is 720. Allocation, given. TAI, how much percentage? Be with me. OPAU, okay, synergies values is 720, sorry. No worries. $720,400 is equal to multiplied by 44.5%. 320, that is the allocation. 400 and 320. 400 and 320. Let's start with the OPAU percentage gain. Now one by one. Total equity value. Equity value after acquisition is equal to whatever the value now. How much the now value? Now value is 5000 plus 320. Now value is 5000. This is the now value of the company. That is 5000. Total value. And after synergy aspect, total value 5320. We are moving towards from total to individual. Then post acquisition share price. What is the post acquisition share price? What is the post acquisition share price? This is what about the post acquisition share price? Be with me. Total company combined value. Is this and post acquisition expected share price? It's very simple. That's 5320. How much number of shares they have? They have a number of shares of 2000. So is equal to 5320 divided by 2000. That is 2.66. So what we will say that? What we will say that? Now OPAO shares to be allocated to TIE shareholders. What is the TIE shareholders? What about the TIE shareholders? Okay, can you please reply me? Are you clear till now? Equity value after acquisition 5320, post acquisition share price expected 2.66. And what about the TIE? If we given to the TIE, then the TIE value is 1000. Plus, we will give more this 400. What is the value? That is equals to 1400. And what? So it means whatever the share price we are giving, whatever the share price, it's based on this 266. Value per share. That's 1400 divided by 2.66. And that is what our value. That is what our value. If OPAO given shares, that means 1400 divided by 2.66. No, 2.5 is the share price. Here we are given 2.66. That's the key point. So we can identify share for share. How share for share? I can rearrange the word. OPAO shares allocation. What is this 526? That means if TIE having 1400 value after acquisition and our share acquisition price is 2.66, that means OPAO have to issue 526 shares. And share for share like this. Share for share like this. TAO shares before acquisition. Before acquisition. And that is 263 million. And we are giving 526 shares. So what we will say, share for share is equal to 526 divided by 263 is equal to 2:1. Means two OPAO shares for one TIE shares. Hello, can you please apply me? How to calculate this? Is that clear confusion? Can you please apply me once again? Actually here, only the data is given. Share for share exchange, that total synergy is allocated this. We need to identify how much number of shares we have to give in. So think about that. How the proportion will be settled? That how much acquirer give number of shares to acquiree. So here we calculate in this manner. First identify what is the worth of per share after acquisition, 2.66, and what TIE will get the total 41,000 plus allocation 400 of synergy 1400, and we will allocate the OPAO share allocation in this manner. Post acquisition 5320 divided by 2.6, that's 526. So 526, if we offer 526 shares over 263 TIE, so that means two OPAO shares of one TIE. Now the situation is clear. Percentage gain. What percentage gain by TIE? Come on. What percentage given by the TIE? And that is what? Quickly, two shares. Receiving two shares of OPAO. So here you will take is equal to what is the share value? 2.66 multiply by two shares, 5.32. Do remember that in the examination hall, listen carefully. I am taking 2.66 post acquisition price. Listen this point, you can take one assumption. This is a very common thing you can do this. For the evaluation of share for share exchange with respect to the target company, in the examination, you can take the acquirer current share price for this 2.5. You can analyze the situation by 2.5, or you can also take the working with 2.66. You can take 2.5 as well. Answer will be right. The analysis based on post acquisition share price or the current share price of the acquirer. Is that clear? You can take any of them, anyone. One share of tie. That is 3.8. So is equal to 5.32 minus 3.8. Percentage gain for two shares, gain per share is equal to 1.52 divided by 2. Gain percentage is equal to 0.76 divided by 3.8. I'm sorry. That is gain. This is not the two shares. This is gain per share. Because we are working for tie. Gain percentage is equal to 1.52 divided by 3.8. That is 40%. Can you please reply me about this? That is gain percentage 40%. Gain percentage 40%. Okay, next. That is tie. And what about the OPAO? What about the OPAO? Come on with the OPAO. It's very simple. What is the expected share price? We have already calculated expected share price 2.66. It's simple. 2.66 minus 2.5 divided by 2.5. So it's equal to 2.66 minus 2.5 divided by 2.5 and into 100. That is only 6.4%. Candidates, accept mix. Yes, I can share the screenshot. I cannot share, but share the screenshot. Okay. Students, the mix offer you can work out by your own. The mix offer cash 2.04 and 1 for OPAO shares for TIE. And it is estimated the share price will be 2.6 per share when the mix offer is made. Okay. This one. You can work out by your own because I don't have enough time because I have to share the, I have to discuss the report here. Moreover, this last line is actually the extra point, not the part of 1, 2, 3, but connect with this part. Since acquisition, similar acquisition in the food manufacturing industry normally attract share price premium 15 to 40%. Okay, so how much till now? with this option. That we have offered tie with the cash 11 and then 40. By the way, I have direct working here for OPAW with a mix offer 23.4%. And here .9.7%. This is actually the answer about. I don't have enough time to discuss the mix offer, but you can work out on. Candidates, take a short break of 3 to 4 minutes. Short break of the 3 to 4 minutes and back to again. A short break of 4 minutes only. Then I will discuss the point of the report writing. That's very much important. Yes, I will discuss. I will share. Don't worry. Okay, students, come on. The last part. The last phase of the session, this required the 15 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes. A lot of chats exist in the AFM group as well, so you can reply me accordingly. Yes, come on. The another part. The requirement that we have done C12. Now the report writing, that's 7 and 4. That is 7 and 4. 7 and 4. Evaluate the likely reaction of OPAO and Thai company shareholders to the acquisition offer, and professional marks, free marks available for the format structure presentation. Now come on. This document just I have shared with you. It's document now available on the forum. And I'm also sharing with the WhatsApp as well. It's now available. This document is now available for all of you. Okay. Okay. Now the another point. Once again, December 18. Question number one, part B. OPAO. Seven plus four here. Yes, 7 plus 4, 11 marks. Number one, 11 marks, 1.8, 20 minutes, 5 minutes planned, 17 marks. (clears throat) 15 minutes for execution, like this. Marks management, all these same things, report format structure, free marks. Core marks, 7. Plan your core marks before writing. What examiner expect from your side? Evaluate likely reaction, both. It means simple evaluation. You have to make evaluation or likely impacts of the OPAO, 3 to 4 marks. Tie 3 to 4 marks. That's all. That is the point. So two things here. Report format structure presentation. That's we already discussed. Report format structure presentation includes this. Report subject to whom? The board of directors of OPAO. Introduction of brief paragraph. All these steps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's called report format structure and presentation. Yes. Now, the important point is that at least 3 to 4, 3 well explained points. Here. And same 3 well explained points here. Based on the conclusion we have made, this is what the conclusion. I strongly suggest whenever you're working with this style, that will support to you. That will support to you for the calculation, for the report writing, because all the things in front of you, the analysis becomes simple. So make, during the calculation, you have to make this type of charts. In fact, also highlight this. So now start. Number one, report format, start report. Report to the board of directors of power company. Introduction, very brief, as already discussed, very brief. Report provides estimate of additional value created of power company to acquire TAI, and report about what additional value created if a power company acquired TAI, and the gain of each company shareholder based on all the offers, and it will evaluate the likely reaction to two companies of the shareholder. I strongly suggest that the first paragraph is what all about the rearrangement of the wordings, the rearrangement of the wordings of requirement. Whatever the requirement, evaluate the reaction, and based on this valuation and percentage gain. This first paragraph is what about the rearrangement of requirement. Rearrangement about the wordings of the requirement. And this is a part of the format matter. Now, because now the main context start. Don't mention the main context word. It's better here that you have to refer the summaries of the estimates. Means you have to put a one line based on the appendix, the relevant extract of the working as values, individual values of the companies, combined value, and the synergy. And appendix two, this one is the gain. You can mention with this on the report writing, no issue at all. And then put the figure accordingly. Evaluate likely reactions. Number one, TAI company. With the cash offer, whatever you think you planned earlier, if TAI company consider the cash offer, it's very precise. You have to think this matter here, what to write. Three well explained points about cash offer. The cash offer having a plus point. Whenever you are taking the points, you have to consider the very important thing. Cash. You will start the point, the highest benefit we are getting from the shares, yes. But the cash having 11.24%. So you will mention 11.24%, which is comparatively lower than the shares and like this. But some plus point is that it's a very precise. Precise means if we accept the cash offer, this is very much precise that what I will get as compared to share. Because with respect to the shares, we are accepting the offer based on the value will become after acquisition. Maybe possible the share price will not exactly as we calculated, but the cash is very much precise, but the cash have tax burden. The cash has tax burden. So you have to think about it before writing. Same case for shares. About the shares, you will mention the highest percentage, 40%, but less precise as compared to cash. But plus point, but more plus point, equity holding maintained and the proportion is higher. Same case mix, cash plus shares. The lowest percentage, this is the lowest offer and not relevant as compared to above. First of all, have to think about in this manner. Move on with the Thai company. Thai company aspect with the cash. First of all, have to consider the lowest one offering the premium, or the highest one getting the premium, that's mix offer. So here the one thing is that Thai have a least concern of the mix offer, but Opao has the maximum they wanted to pay with the mix offer. So it's a rift between that. What will actual happen? It's not the question. Actual finalization will depend on the negotiation at the final meeting. But comparing the cash offer, need immediate cash. Need immediate cash. But higher benefit as compared to shares. Shares offer no need immediate cash. But benefit is lowest side, then you have to put the mix matter like this. First have to think, prepare your mind, then start working accordingly. Candidates, can you please reply me? Is that clear how to write the thing? How to write the answer accordingly? And then make a final conclusion. Sometimes question is about that. The situation is not very clear, like this case. You have to mention this. Based on the benefit accruing to the both set of shareholder, not possible to conclusively say that one method of acquisition payment will be acceptable to both shareholder. Here we are not 100% sure which method is more acceptable, but you have to use the word however, this wording is very much important. Both shareholder may persuade that mixed offer reasonable comprise between holy cash, holy shares. given synergy benefits not equally, all these things with your own wordings. So candidates, this is what, how to write the answer. That's I have provided you the direction. With the case of acquisition merger and like this. Students, this is all about today's session. By tomorrow's session, I will discuss some more. I will provide you some more guidance for acquisition mergers, reorganization and reconstructions. More guidance. Then I will move with the question of the forex and the swaps. So tomorrow I have a plan to work out with the two components, more about acquisition mergers plus something reconstruction, reorganization, and then forex including swap. And the last day, fifth day, that's for the remaining part, some interest, some remaining parts of the tomorrow's of the fourth session. Yes, you will get the pocket notes of the acquisition mergers and the business reorganization by tomorrow morning with the Google Drive, where you can view. I cannot discuss the method of the CIV here. You can ask me on the WhatsApp group. It's very simple, like residual value. And for CIV, I strongly suggest you have to refer the Kaplan book, a basic exercise, number one. And number two, then attempt the half company question, the half company question. So candidates, if you feel that that particular session valuable for you, do reply me, constructive reply me on the WhatsApp group and on the forum. Constructive reply. ACCA management, can you please share the WhatsApp link on the platform? Do reply me a constructive reply over this. Have you got the benefit from the today's session? What benefit you get? Calculation with theory, but particular topic. Your feedback will be highly appreciable. That's good. Hamza, you can ask me if you are not comfortable with me. Once you review the question accordingly, then ask me accordingly. Okay, thank you very much from my side. ACCA management, we can close the session. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.